गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू हैव सीन आवर लास्ट वीडियो ऑन एनालिटिकल पेटी कैश बुक इन विच आई गिव ए लिटिल इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट परचेज बुक। सो टुडे वी विल हैव अनदर क्वेश्चन विच इज बेस्ड ऑन आवर परचेज बुक। एज आई टोल्ड, वी रिकॉर्ड ऑल आवर कैश एंट्रीज इन टू द कैश बुक, बट वी डू नॉट पोस्ट आवर क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन इन टू द कैश बुक। सो For recording the credit transaction, we have a set of books, that is purchase book, sales book, purchase return books and sales return book. So we need to post credit entry in these books. Today we will have some entries for purchase book. So let's start with a question. Mr. Naren and Company from Delhi is a trader into the stationery products. We need to make a purchase book for him. He deals into the stationery product and we need to prepare a purchase book for Mr. Naren. Maybe he have cash entries also in this and credit transaction also, but we need to choose only credit transaction to post into cash book, because as we know, for cash transaction we have cash book to post entries. So let's start with the few purchase entry that Mr. Naren did into the last 5 days, February 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we need to post all these entries into the purchase book. Today we are going to discuss how to post into the purchase book. So on the first date, 2020, Feb 1st, Mr. Naren purchased goods from Mr. Brown and Company, and the details of purchase is 5 gross pencil at the rate 1200 per gross, 2 dozen registers at the rate 500 per dozen, and less trade discount. After 2 purchases, he also got the discount of 10% from Mr. Brown. So how to post this entry? We need to first put the name of the seller whom we are purchasing the goods. MS Brown and Company. We purchase goods from MS Brown and Company. First thing that we purchase, that is 5 gross pencils. 5 gross pencils at the rate 1200 per gross. Next thing we purchase, 2 dozen registers at the rate 500 per dozen. Now we need to sum up the cost, that 5 gross pencil at the rate 1200 per gross, then it will go 6000, 1200 into 5, and 2 dozen register at the rate 500 per dozen, then it will go 1000, 500 into 2. So the total amount of goods that we purchased from Mr. Brown, that is 7000. Now we need to put that amount into the outer column, but because we received a trade discount from Mr. Brown, so we need to post that trade discount also. It is go like that, less trade discount at the rate 10%. So we will receive 10% trade discount on whole of the purchased amount, that is 7000, and trade discount is 10%, then it will go 700, 10% of 7000. Then the amount is 7000 minus 700, and in outer column it will go 6300. In last video we already discussed this entry about the trade discount. Same entry we doing again today. That is, we need to deduct trade discount from the gross amount. This is the gross amount of the goods purchased from Mr. Brown, and after trade discount we got actual amount that we need to pay to the Mr. Brown. After this we have to close the account, because we do not have any further entry on Feb 1, so we need to close for Feb 1. This is we done for Feb 1. Now we need to move on Feb 2. On Feb 2 we have entry Purchased 4 cash from the stationery mart. 10 dozen exercise book at the rate 300 per dozen. So we purchased amount 3000 exercise book from the stationery mart. But in this entry, they clearly mention that we purchased into the cash and purchase book is only for the credit purchase. As we discussed in the earlier classes, that purchase book is only for credit purchases, sales book is only for credit sales, purchase return is only for credit purchase returns. So, if there is any cash entry, that we need to put into the cash book, not to post into purchase book. So, we will not post this cash transaction into the purchase book. And on Fab 2, we do not have another entry, so we will move on Fab 3. On Fab 3, we have purchased computer printer for office use from MS Office Goods and Company for 20,000. There is another entry because Mr. Naren and Company is trading into the stationery. So stationery is a goods for him. He is trading, purchasing and selling those goods. He purchased from outside of the state and he can purchase from within the state and then he can sell to within the state and out of the state also. But if he is purchasing computer printer for office use or any other things, any other assets like building, car, these are the assets, not the goods. Goods are those which we trade on daily basis or weekly basis. But asset we can't trade on weekly basis or daily basis. So this is also a purchase of asset, not a purchase of goods. And as I told in class that for purchase of goods, we record only in purchase book. Other any purchase we record into the journal proper. That is the sixth book that we have. That is for these type of transaction. The purchase of fixed assets, sale of fixed asset, gain on sale of fixed asset. So these type of transaction we record into the sixth book, that is journal proper. We have separate book for that. That is journal proper. We do not record any purchase of asset into the purchase book. If Mr. Naren and Company is a dealer of computer, then the purchase of computer is a good for him because he will sell it or he can purchase it. But if he is trading into the stationery and he is purchasing computer and printer for his office, then these both are the assets for the Mr. Naren and Company. So purchase of an asset we will not record into the purchase book. We need to record only the purchase of stationery into the purchase book because MS Naren and Company a trader in stationery, not in a computer. So we will not post about Feb 3rd also. Then we go on Feb 4th. For Feb 4th, we have entry. That is, we are purchasing from the paper and company, Delhi. We are purchasing goods from paper and company, Delhi. So earlier we purchased from Mr. Brown. Now Mr. Naren purchasing from paper and company, Delhi. That is 8 reams of white paper. 8 reams of white paper at the rate 500 per unit. Then he is purchasing 10 reams of ruled paper at the rate 600 per unit. Reams means the bundle. He is purchasing from paper and company. What he is purchasing? 8 bundles of white paper at the rate of 500 per unit and 10 bundles of rolled paper that is also cost 600 per unit. So the total cost he will get for these two purchases is 4,000 and 10,666, 6,000. So this is the total gross amount amount we purchased goods from the paper and company Delhi. After that, there is another transaction on Feb 4, that is less trade discount at the rate 10%. We received a trade discount also from paper and company Delhi, that is 10% of the total amount. as we did in earlier entry, less trade discount. In this entry also we will put this less trade discount at the rate 10% of the gross amount. This is the gross amount, that is 10,000. 10% of 10,000 is 1,000. And this amount we need to put, remaining amount we need to put on outer column, that is 9,000. So this is the entry for purchase of stationery, that from first time from Mr. Brown, then from Paper and Company Delhi. Between we both, we go through transaction on Feb 2nd and Feb 3rd. That is, on Feb 2 we did a cash purchase. So for cash purchase, we have a separate book, that is cash book. We do not mention it in purchase books. On another day, we purchased fixed assets, and for purchase and sale of fixed asset, we also have another book, that is journal proper, in which we record all these type of transaction. Purchase book is only for those transaction in which we are dealing, because Mr. Naren is dealing into the stationery goods only, so we will record only the transaction related to the stationery. If Mr. Naren sell his old newspaper from office, it will also not post into the sales book. Or if he purchased old newspaper from market, it is not a purchase for him, because it is not a part of stationery. Then it will also go to the journal proper. That book is for recording all these type of transactions. We have another entry on Feb 5th, that is purchase 80 Reynolds pen at the rate 5 each from MS Verma Brothers, Delhi. So now we are purchasing Reynolds pen. So this is also a stationery, so we will post this entry. But first we need to close the entry for Feb 4th, because we do not have more entries for Feb 4. This is the okay. Our next entry is purchase 80 pens of Reynolds pen from MS Verma Brothers. So on Feb 5, we purchased good from MS Verma Brothers. How much we purchased? We purchased 80 Reynolds pen at the rate of 5 each. So we purchased 80 Reynolds pens at the rate 5 each. Then the total cost will be 400. After this, we have a transaction, another entry, that is freight charges rest 100. Freight charges we are paying fare on purchase. Freight may be we are picking up those goods to our home, or maybe to our warehouses. So we paid another freight charges to the Mr. Verma and Brothers. So this will also add in the cost of the our purchase. Might be Mr. Verma paying freight on sending all these goods to our home or to our warehouse. So this will also add into the cost, because Mr. Verma charge this amount is also from us, because he is sending to home by our expenses, not by him ex by his expenses. So we need to add these expenses in our cost, that amount that we purchased from him. So we need to add freight charges rest 100. Then the total will be go on outer column is 500. So this is how we post entry into the purchase book. Then we will post this total into our purchase account on the last date of the month, because we are posting into the 2020 year, so it is a leap year. On Feb 29, we need to close our account. So first we need to close Feb 5th entry, that is done. Now what we need to do, we need to transfer all the sum of these purchases to the purchase account. Purchases account debit. And the total is 15,800, then we need to double cross, that is for closure of account. Why we are transferring the purchase this amount into the purchase account? Because purchase account is for both of the transaction. In purchase account, as we studied in ledger account, we record both the transaction, whether it is for purchase of goods on cash basis, whether it is purchase of goods on from bank, whether it is purchase of goods on credit basis. So purchase account is only for purchases, whether it is for credit or whether it is for cash or bank transaction, it will not affect the posting of entries into the purchase account. Purchase account is a ledger account and purchase book is a journal book. So there is a difference. Purchase book record only the credit purchases. Remaining cash purchases we record into the cash book, and the other assets purchases we record into the journal book. But purchase book is for every type of purchase other than the fixed asset. For fixed asset, we have to maintain a separate account for that fixed asset if we are purchasing the fixed asset. But for purchasing of goods, whether it is on cash basis, whether it is on credit basis, we need to post into the purchase account. But first, we have to maintain our purchase book, that is for credit purchase. And for cash transaction, we will took all the transaction of cash purchases from the cash book, because we are paying through bank or we are paying through cash. So this is how we post entries into the purchase book. Because Mr. Naren and company is a trader into the stationery, so we will record only the purchase of the stationeries. Other transaction, whatever he is doing, purchasing any electrical equipment for his home or purchase of any machinery for his factory, it will not we will not post that entry into the purchase book, because purchase book is only for that type of goods in which we are trading. So there is a difference. If I am trading into the stationery, then stationery purchase or sale of stationery is a goods for me. But purchase or sale of any asset is not goods for me, because goods are those in which we deal on daily basis or on weekly basis. If I am purchasing car for 2 year, if I purchased a car for 2 year, that is purchase of asset, not a purchase of goods. But if I am a dealer of car and then I am purchasing and selling the car, then it will come into the goods. Because still I am paying a big amount for that car, but it is now my business to purchase and sale of car. Maybe I purchased or sale on daily or weekly basis, so then it will be a business. And in the same case, if I am purchasing car from other and selling car, then I will also record into the purchase book, because now I am a trader into the car. But if I am trading into the cars and I purchase a truck, then it will asset for me, not a good, because goods are those in which we transact on daily basis or weekly basis. And truck I purchased for my office use, not for reselling purpose. But if I started selling and purchasing of truck also, then it will also come into the goods, because I am selling or purchasing the truck also on daily and weekly basis. So there is a difference between goods and purchase of assets. Hope everyone you got how to post entries into the purchase book. It is very simple. You do not have to do anything much. What you need to do, just put the name of the seller whom we are purchasing the goods, that is like Mr. Brown and Company, Paper and Company Delhi, and Mr. Verma and Brothers. After this, what we purchased from them, this thing. If we are receiving any discount, we need to subtract from our total purchase. And if we are paying any freight, we need to add up into our total cost. It is basically an example. If you purchased a TV from any shop and you said that you have to send it to my home and I will pay your charges, whatever it come. So you purchased TV for 16,000 and the sending cost of TV to your home is 500. The seller will add into the bill. That is we called freight. Seller took that freight from us because he is not liable for that freight, because we purchased that thing. It is our responsibility to take that thing from the seller to our home. So if he is sending that thing to our home, so it is now our responsibility to pay all the freight and the charges to the seller. So this is how we post entries into the purchase book. So what you need to do, you need to keep revise and try to post entries into the purchase book.